digging deeper just to throw it away. I bleed it out, digging deeper.
It's time for Wubba Wildcat.
That was a workout.
I'm wiped.
It was all over in 30 seconds.
Yes, sounds like somebody I know.
And are you complaining? Anyway, speaking of complaining, aren't you sick of hearing people complain when they're camping that they've got nothing to do and that they're bored?
Oh yeah, absolutely. It's the worst thing, you go camping, you listen to people whinge and complain. But I think that the possible reason that people are complaining, Jack, is because they actually have no idea what they're doing.
Yes, well, thankfully we won't have that problem anymore because our good mate, Robbo the Yobbo, has brought his camping extravaganza to Hit TV and he's going to show us all the things that you can do to keep you away from boredom when you're camping.
Wonderful. That is definitely what we need. We need some tips from Robbo.
We do. Here it is, Robbo the Yobbo's camping extravaganza on Hit TV.
Howdy, I'm Robbo the Yobbo. Excuse the voice, because I know it's a bit rusty, but old Robbo was up around the campfire and had a few too many beers last night. But it ain't going to hold me back. And I'm going to show you how to have fun when you're out in the bush. Now, Robbo always hears people whinging about, oh, there's nothing to do in the bush. How do we keep ourselves amused? Well, I'll tell you a great way to keep yourself amused. Trees, they are a great source of entertainment in the bush. You can climb them. You can even have a good old heart-to-heart with a tree. And I'd give up forever to touch you, 'cause I know. Some people like to kick the footy in the bush, but I like to kick the dirt. When you're in the bush, hunting is a necessity. That's why I brought my hunting dog, Butch. Now, if you can't find anything to hunt, your dog is always a good source of food. So lucky I brought my oriental friend and he's gonna help us cook up some dim sims. Aren't you, bud? Until next time, I'm Robbo. Catch you later.
Well, I love that segment. You know, I haven't been camping in a while, but I think after seeing Robbo the Yobbo's camping extravaganza that I have got everything that I need to know to go out and do some bush bashing and get the old camping gear out.
Yeah, well, that sounds like a good idea, Jack. Maybe you could, take a loved one camping.
Yeah, well, if I had a loved one, you know, maybe I could, but,
Well, yeah.
Anyway, aren't you starting up a new segment that could maybe help me find a loved one?
Oh, well, Jack, you can't be helped.
Huh.
But if you're a tradesman, then you can be. We have a fantastic new game show, a dating game show with a twist. The girls and I got out on campus at Holmes Glen and we went to find ourselves some sexy tradesmen. And let me tell you, we got the cream of the crop. There is plenty to choose from, ladies. And we asked them a little bit about themselves, got some little insights into them. So I'm not going to tell you too much right now, but watch this. This is the perfect trade on Hit TV.
Have you been waiting to watch yet another useless guy strut his stuff on some boring dating game show? Well, if you have, then I suggest you turn your television set off right about now.
Working hard to make a living, bringing shelter from the rain. A father, son,
beautiful.
Carry on blue denim in his vein.
So, you know how to use wood?
I do know how to use wood.
We'll take three hot young men, each working a different trade, and we'll get them to fight it out for the love of a woman and to prove that theirs is the perfect trade.
Rose, when do we get to see the rest of that?
Very soon. All you've got to do is tune in a fortnight's time and you'll be able to see what we get up to with those boys. That's the perfect trade in 2 weeks' time.
Yeah.
It's going to be fantastic.
What an amazing show we've had. Why is it so close to me?
This is a cool cushion. I like strawberries. You can eat them. They taste like strawberries. Anyway, guys, I'm just here to let you know that, well, first of all, the audience needed to see me one more time.
Huh.
And just to let you guys know that you did a really good job today.
Yeah, that's a goddamn lie.
No, it's not a lie. That's a good thing.
Oh, no, yeah. Thanks, Josh. Appreciate it.
No worries.
Well, if you feel the same as Josh and you think we did a good job, come in, tune in next week, and we'll have another fresh show with some fresh faces. Fortunately, we won't be the host.
We won't be here. But, I know that that's a terrible thing, but
yes.
You know, the next hosts are going to be fantastic.
Yeah, so I can't wait for that one. So, thanks, guys. See you later.
Y'all come back now.
Until next time, guys.